And you will see also Asma radiallahu anha and what she did, but that comes a little bit later. Now the Quraysh, they are tracking. And immediately using the expert trackers, they find Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would be walking on his toe, on the balls of his feet, to make sure the tracks are not there. But these trackers were experts. This was their profession. This was their livelihood. And for 200 camels, they found the mountain. And they told the Quraysh, this is where they are. And the Quraysh, they got their weapon. They started to go up. And this is a sahih hadith that is pointed towards in the Quran itself. This is clearly mentioned in Al-Bukhari, Ibn Hisham, Ibn Saq. All of them document this. That when the Quraysh, they came up, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he saw them coming. And he became afraid. SubhanAllah, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu becomes afraid. One of the filthy Rafida, the filth that they have, he said something ajeeb. From the disease that's in their heart. And I hope some of them watch this later. They said that, look, Ali, he's so brave. He's in the bed of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is even gone, and he's by himself, and he's not afraid. And Abu Bakr here, he's in the grave, he's in the cave, and he's afraid. If these Rafida, if these filthy people had only read, if they only had sight of the eyes of the heart, they would have read what Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, Wallahi, O Messenger of Allah, I'm not afraid for me. I am a Muslim from amongst the Muslims. I am a Muslim from amongst the Muslims. If the Quraysh catch me and kill me, I will be a shaheed like every other Muslim's wish, desire to become shaheed. But I'm afraid for you, because you are the most important man. You are the Messenger of Allah. If they kill you, the hidayah will stop. The nur of guidance will stop. The revelation of the Quran will stop. That is what I'm afraid of. Abu Bakr radiallahu was never afraid for himself. But he was worried for his beloved friend, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he tells him, O Rasulullah, I am afraid for you that if they catch us and they kill us, what will happen? Here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he replies Abu Bakr radiallahu. In the famous hadith, and it is mentioned authentically, told them, Uskut, be quiet, Ya Aba Bakr, O Abu Bakr, Al-Ithnan, Allahu Thalithu Ma'ahuma. That we are the two, and Allah is the third with us. SubhanAllah. That if we are two, don't think we are alone. The help of Allah, the malaika of Allah, the sight of Allah, the ilm of Allah, the qudra of Allah, all of that power of Allah is with us. And we discuss in our aqidah dars that when we say Allah is with us, what is meant and what we know from the Quran and the authentic hadith and the sayings of Mufassirun of the Quran, that is meant is not in that, not in self, but in sight, in knowledge, in qudra, in help, with the malaika. So here, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, don't worry, Allah is with us. Now, why did the Quraysh not go into the cave? There are some narrations that I will mention them, and I will mention their authenticity and weakness to clarify this issue. Some of the ulama, they mention in their respective books that there was a spider that made its web around the opening of this cave. And the Quraysh, when they went and they saw this, they said, how could it be that two men have just passed in here and a spider has made this big web? Because we know that if there was a web, it would have been broken. And if two men just went in, a spider would not make this big web so fast after that.